little bit of slope on our left,
yes,
and it's down on the right.
Yeah, okay.
So be conscious of what the wing's doing and be careful not to touch the ground. You have control.
Okay,
I'm on the control.
I have control.
All out.
Hold it, set, look. There we go. Look sideways in transition. Bring it up, bring it up. Beautiful. Keep looking, speed and angle. You're fine.
Bring the speed. Hell, that's fast.
That's okay. Push it back, it'll bring the speed back. Beauty. You're saying lay off, I think. Yeah, this is me.
Okay.
So that's speed laying off.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, please, in case you're in the
zone. I can't see anything down there. Right. Oh, look, what's
happening?
So, 45 knots. No. Come on, dickhead. 45 knots. Couldn't actually see the zone, unfortunately. So, look at the varios.
Yeah.
Trim us back a tiny bit, and
we've
got something here, haven't we?
Yeah. Feet.
Okay, now it's a bit gusty.
Yeah.
Keep it around 45 for now, just for say to give you a few extra knots.
Okay.
Excellent. I would just gently turn left, Mike. Are you happy to do that?
Yeah.
That's it. Just together, okay. That's enough. Let's go along the ridge and see what's happening. You stay on, but would you mind if I join you?
No, you carry on.
Thank you. You stay on the stick. I'm just going to get a tiny bit over towards the edge. Just to see if we can find a bit that's going to keep us up.
It's just a little bit, isn't there? Not much.
Okay. Anyway, this is the first time on the ridge. We just want to check if there's any turbulence and sink.
Yeah.
We'll keep the speed a little higher. Of course, we'll turn away from the ridge when we do a turn. There we go.
Yeah.
This is good. Look at that inside.
Yeah.
That's good. And we can afford now, because we're going up at 3 meters, 6 knots.
Yeah.
We can afford just to trundle along here for a little while longer because we're adding height. We don't have a tailwind going back, it's a very slight tailwind. It's actually be a crosswind going back. I'm just going to turn out. You don't mind if I just explore
this one
beat? We know there's something there, so you'll have a good flight. Going too slow again, we don't know what the turbulence is like the first time. There we go, it's lovely. There we go, it's back. A little bit of wind. We know we've got this 500-600 meters till the end of the trees is definitely broken. It's just going to turn us out. I'll just add 100 feet or two if that's alright. You can carry on.
Yeah, yeah.
Right there, we're just approaching the edge of those trees. 4 meters, that's 8 knots on the ridge. Quite a powerful wind too, we're up to 1400.
Yeah.
Just going to feel this bit, so I'll just check out the whole ridge. We'll have the cave. We'll have the peak. Have you got a radio?
No.
I've got it. You take over now, Mike, will you?
Okay.
You have control?
I have control.
Just up here, start to turn to the right. Winch 13, it was a tiny bit fast. We got above about 65. Our ridge is doing well here.
PW, if you're listening in, what was your launch like?
Look for
the
PW.
Yeah, it's down here.
Brilliant. We're going to do the beat now. You're flying, Mike.
Okay.
You knew where we were before. Fly a little bit ahead. You know the trees here.
Yeah.
Just be slightly forward of the crown of that
W,
bitch.
What was your launch like?
There you go. Look at your barrier. That's it. You're flying. I'm off the controls.
Okay.
Now, track along, you see where we're, you can't see where I'm pointing. Up there, track along there, that's it.
Yeah.
Modify your speed, now look at this. Bring your few knots off.
Woohoo!
Yeah, if you feel you want better control, don't take a few knots off.
Yeah. No, it's just gusty like that and just kicks you up the arse.
That's why you want the extra speed if you feel it. Let me just stay on the controls.
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay, about there, okay.
Let me, again, if you don't mind,
okay.
I'm just going to modify the speed. Yours, you have control.
Okay.
With that 8 knots. That's good, we're doing 50, so just like, that's actually the lift that's moving you around.
Yes.
Push the right wing down, the left wing down a touch. That lift is trying to raise it. Just went up 200 feet. Doing well.
I don't know where the
area, look at the speed, yeah. And then a really good look around.
The PW's behind us. Yeah.
Can you see him?
Yeah, he's turned, he's going behind us at 7 o'clock.
Brilliant, away or
away from us now.
When you're ready, you can do the same. Turn away from the ridge. The speed is safe. Nice turn. String is perfect. So go back, so you're going to do more than 180 and go back towards the ridge, crown of the ridge. Keep it going around, Mike. The wind will help now, it's under the wing. That's it, beautiful. Nice turn. The string is lovely actually, that's good. Expect some lift, we're going to capitalize on it by not having too much speed, but you must feel safe. Let me help as well if you wouldn't mind.
Say again.
You keep flying.
Yeah.
He's clear, but he will try and catch, he's going to catch us up shortly.
Yeah.
So I just want to make sure we can get up a little higher.
Okay.
Here it comes, you feel that lift?
Yeah.
We can just help it a tad. Look at the speed on the Vario, 6 knots.
Crazy.
Going up another 100 feet. Lovely. That's it.
I don't know where he is now.
As we concentrate on flying, I'm going to keep a good lookout. You keep a good lookout too.
Yeah.
He has climbed up a little quicker than us, probably because it's you flying, but you've just climbed us 300 feet on that beat. Go back. Good look as you're turning, because he might be behind us. We always turn out from the ridge. I can't see it.
No, I can't.
You may be exploring the rest of it. We'll stay here to see how high the lift goes. It's okay, he's not here. There he is, out on our right.
Oh yeah, I've got him.
Yeah, so may I fly for a few seconds?
Yeah,
just
sure.
A few seconds.
You've got it.
Thank you, I've got control. He's just exploring the upper ridge, back there.
Yeah.
I just want to see how smooth I'm flying. If you're coming head to head with somebody on the ridge, the guy that's got the ridge on the right has the right of way. We weren't head to head, so we stayed there.
Yeah.
And he was slightly low. Look at Vario.
Yeah, wow.
So it's just here, there's a half a kilometer where we get 6 or 8 knots. See, I'm making tiny inputs just to keep us still and capitalize on it.
Yeah.
I'm ready any second to move the stick forward if we get buffeted. Look at that, 2 grand. Stunning.
Good
lucky
stuff.
Son of a gun.
Cheap.
I have to say already, considering you haven't flown for some time, your turning is very good. But you see, the reason I just took it then wasn't to climb 200 feet, was to show you we can be a little stiller in the air.
Yeah.
Just by making tiny inputs.
Yeah.
So you take control.
Okay, I have control.
That felt like a little bit more lift, so stay there, Mike. Just take that until it disappears. We're still climbing. Now I would turn, it's disappeared.
Can't see him.
Really good look. Just gently turn initially until you've got to have a chance to look.
Oh, he's above us and behind.
Okay,
9 o'clock high.
Oh, he's done well. We'll go there. Your GoPro is pointing quite high. And go back to the upper ridge, see where the two masts are?
Yeah.
There you go. I've just touched the stick briefly and it felt like you're a bit rigid on it, so you can press a couple of fingers.
Okay.
I'm not sure if he's surfing or he's on the ridge, so keep going back. Watch your Vario and your speed. Don't let the speed get too high. There we go, that's it. That was me just gently pushing. So just now, turn to your right and go along the front of the road here. Is he circling or not?
He looks to be circling,
that's
yeah.
Me trying to adjust as well there, mister.
Okay.
Just to put us there. What are we getting?
2 down at the moment.
Okay, we'll go over under him and he has a thermal. That'll be good for you turning. Just be like, I'm just gently touching it every now and again. Just relax a tiny bit. Look at your Vario, you can see something's happening.
Yeah.
He's well clear, so just concentrate on your speed. We're a tiny bit faster still. And here, you look at your Vario.
Yeah.
A couple of seconds, start a left. We have to go the same as him. Go left, Mike. That's it, good man. We're going to go up here at 45 knots. Let me help if I may.
Yeah.
Stay on the controls.
Yeah.
We're a tiny bit far back. I'm just bringing the trim back. Right, it's not as strong here, so it's a little ahead of us. You see he's...
Yes.
There we go. I'm going to adjust so we get a slightly upwind of us.
Don't forget the cable.
And they're just going to find where we had. We had 3-4 knots. Right, so what we know is there are thermals around because he's circling. We also know that the ridge is working there.
Yeah.
I can't find that one now. It should be about here. So I'm just going to keep looking up for him. Have you done the stalling yet, Mike?
Yeah, I had one quick one with Ken a little while ago.
This is sinking, so this is no good. Well, we're going to move out a bit.
Yeah.
He's still high up here.
Oh yeah, there he is, right above us. Long way above us. Big sinking.
Yeah, we're sinking. I'm just going to try and get under here. He stopped turning. Let's have a little look at what he's doing. If not, we'll go along the ridge again. You can take it off me. I'm just having a little hunt. He's stopped turning, so he's lost it, whatever.
Yeah.
That may have been a big bubble. Okay, take control, Mike.
Okay, I've got it.
You have control.
Okay.
We'll leave him there for now. Don't, again, you tend to push us to 55-ish. 45 to 50 is okay, we think, but we've had no problems.
Okay.
But if you just look up to your right, see the white cloud?
Yeah.
We've got two options. We'll do the ridge walk first.
Yeah.
And we might find there's enough there to let us circle in it. We're well above the ridge, so we can afford to circle safely. So just position yourself when you're ready along the crown of the ridge or slightly out of it. You have to look forward when you start your turn. You're doing well, actually, not a problem, but the more you look down the wing, you need to be glancing forward, attitude, angle of bank, speed, string, and then in the direction of turn for safety. So here we go. We know we're climbing again, so we can go back over 2,000 doing this. Head a tiny bit further out, I think. You get the hang of it as you go up and down, you know, where the best bit is.
Yeah.
And just take a couple of knots off, but keep the nose outwards, that's it. And we're climbing again. A couple of knots off. See that we just went up to 6 meters.
Yeah.
So that's 3 meters, that's 6 knots. When I say to you take a few knots off, you have to feel comfortable. I don't want you to feel like you're going a bit slow. You play
yeah.
a bit the same.
Yeah, that's okay. It's come out of it again.
We got airborne at 25 past, so that's 13, 14 minutes now.
Come on, where's the lift gone again?
Well, it's not there. Turn out, away from the ridge then. A feel for it. It might be a little further out. I'll try and spot this. Number 6 and rudder, keep the turn going so that we're...
I've got no means of taking them down to you.
That's it. Where's the PW? Directly ahead.
Straight ahead of us, yeah.
Up, yep.
No land rover,
this turn back onto your ridge, mate.
Okay, we don't know that, so we're sending the other one.
Can I take it again for a second?
Yeah.
Stay on if you wish. I have control. Just going to explore back here a wee bit. Just in case the rear, because it does work all the way back here as well. Once the wind gets over the top and clear of these gullies and things.
Yeah.
So we've still got plenty of height, just in case it's not working. Seems different, something's different now. Is the wind, I can't see the sock.
No.
Can't see any
I wonder
smoke.
If it's shifted round a bit.
Yeah, if it has gone more to the north, it'll take less of it off the hill.
Yeah.
Sorry, it'll take more of it off the hill. I can't quite make the sock out. I think there's a bit more north in it. Just try along here then. And you can try for a thermal back there where the PW is.
Okay. can't see him now.
Now, just about on the crest, there's the edge of the trees ahead of us where you've got the straight line of the trees.
Yeah.
This has been, in the last few weeks, it's been the best place, except for the last week, so we'll just try that. It's a bit of a kick. Are you feeling the controls with me?
Yes.
Just trying to be still and smooth. You feel what the air's doing?
It's
not great, is it?
No, it's just gone.
The windsock is still...
It's where we took off, it's not changed much.
Yeah, it's still horizontal, but it must be from the north now, because that bit's not working. Okay, take control, Mike.
Okay, I've got it.
You have control.
I have control.
Enter a piece of hill. If it is from the north, that knob, that's me.
Yeah.
That knob ahead of us.
Yeah.
Might be, the wind might be catching in that.
Okay.
You can't see the PW, can you?
No.
Okay. I'll do the lookout then. You do the immediate front of us. I'll look, scan all of that.
Oh, PW is 1 o'clock.
Okay, look at your barrier. Look at your speed. You've got some lift there.
Yeah. It's like shifted onto the end of the ridge, isn't it?
Yeah, it may have done. Because it's just catching on these knobs here.
Yeah.
That's me, just to keep us level. You have control?
I have control.
So we are climbing. Let go to the end, and then we've got two options. We can actually try... I'd go back and get some more height, but then we can try above the quarry.
Okay.
The sock is...
Yeah.
The private gliders are out, so we'll have more spotters for us. I'll go back because we're sinking. Turn out. Look at your string when you start your turn, Mike. Good safety look, then look forward, and then another look once you're established. Just a couple of seconds ahead. There you go. So we might get a little bit more here. Keep the speed down. Watch the PW, he might suddenly pick up a thermal or something, we can join him.
Yeah.
Yeah, so when you enter a turn, have a really good look in the direction you're going to turn, and as back as far as you can, above and below the wing. Then you look forward as you commence your turn. He's coming in a little closer, so it might not be working out there, so I'd come a tiny bit closer too.
Just a little bit, isn't
it? A tiny bit of back pressure, that's it. Just to hold your speed. We're trimmed all the way back, the nose still wants to go down, so
yeah.
If you just keep your fingers curled, when you need your nose down, you can uncurl your fingers.
Right.
And you get another 5 knots.
Okay.
Look at your vario, look at your speed.
Yeah.
So position yourself. We're tracking nicely. Don't let your speed increase, otherwise we'll... that's lovely. Dead smooth. Like that, your string is perfect, lovely. We're tracking slightly to our right, beautiful. Dead smooth as well, you've really smoothed out now, that's great. And notice, he's not much higher than us, so he hasn't moved too well. Just monitor your vario too, so you can see which bit of the hill is doing what.
Yeah, it's definitely, oh, there we go again.
So it's look out, he's behind us, he's moving away from us, he's 300 feet higher. There you go, dead smooth, there is a bit here. Everything we can add is good. Okay, I'm inclined to suggest going back again.
Okay.
Because it's dropped off now, if we carry on, we'll keep sinking. Look forward, establish your bank, attitude, string, speed. Now safety look. Right, we're clear, look forward again, check it's all right. Go back to the same position you were on, Mike, so it's a more than, it's more like a 270 than a 90. String, you didn't look forward.
No, sorry.
Safety look. Right, now we can look for the BW, we know he's out there somewhere. He may be only just a little left. Come back to the right. He may be... concentrate on your turns. I'll do the scan. So he may already is higher than us. He's still 3 feet higher.
Yeah, I've got him.
So you must position yourself. We're not quite in the same place. We're too far back. So let's go. See the knob just ahead of you, Mike?
Yeah.
That's the one you'd be aiming at. There's another one. It's not quite as extreme. It's here.
Okay.
So, this is me, okay?
Yeah.
Just to hold us there, you have. There you go.
Okay.
Milk this, we want a few hundred feet back because we lost height on that last bit. Just let the wing stay horizontal, that's it. This is me actually, because that was good, so
yeah.
Now you must do that. Good man. Good, we went up 100 feet, got a bit back. We want this, so milk it to the end. Don't, we just keep the wings level, that's it. How's it feeling?
All right.
You comfy?
Yeah.
It's gone? Do you want to try across the other hill?
Yeah, fine.
We may find we're going to run short and we'll head back to High Key. If not, we can head, if we've got enough, we can head for High Key along this ridge again.
Okay.
Okay. Put a tiny bit of speed on and get there sharpish. We'll have a slight, we have got a tailwind here, so it'll get us there quickly. And it might be catching in this quarry, so head for the one on the right, straight ahead, that's it. Try and keep us heading at that quarry without rocking around too much. That's nice. The wind's coming up again. It'll be any second if we're going to get it. If not, we'll have enough height to fly back along the other ridge. Let's have a little feel of it. Gentle turn away from the ridge now, please. Good safety check and then look forward. That's it. Nice and smooth. We're trying to feel what's happening, if anything. Nice and smooth. Feel the air moving?
Yeah.
Just stay, you stay on. I'm just going to adjust. Let's have a little feel of this. There's a little bit of lift there. We'll get enough to go back if nothing else. That's me helping. Okay, yeah, do you mind?
No, not at all.
Stay on, please. Yep. Wasn't great. I'm going to go really the other way. Look for the PW.
No, gone again.
Try spotting if you can. Especially in the direction we're going and where he might be coming from. He was higher than us. Looking for a bit just here. Okay, now we're not doing well, so we're now already thinking about High Key.
Yeah.
So which is directly ahead of us. We'll try to make it in that direction along the ridge. There's a little bit of lift here. So just I'll add that height. Thank you very much. 100 feet gone on.
Still can't see the PW.
Keep spotting. I can see him.
Can you?
If you look right ahead at the concrete factory.
Yeah.
He's above it.
Oh, yeah, wow.
Just
okay.
Make him out. His wing's level. He's very pale.
Yeah.
And he's 400-500 feet higher than us.
Yeah.
We're still just gently going up, so we're okay. I did two things. I just kept the wings level and just held the stick slightly forward. You can see him now. He's turned the wings.
Yes, yeah, I can see him now.
He's at the far end. Not much higher actually, he's only about 300 feet higher. Look at the sock. The sock has still got a lot of west in it, hasn't it?
Yes.
So it looks like it's come back to the west suddenly.
Yeah.
So we'll carry on along here. We've still got enough height to get us comfortably to High Key. Do you want to take over at this point?
Yeah.
More or less track where we are, Mike. So
okay.
Keep us going. Look along to your right, towards the concrete factory.
Yeah.
Track along there.
Okay.
You have control.
I have control.
This is me.
Yeah.
There you go, yours. Quick scan of your speed and your vario as well to judge what's happening, and then we'll keep our eye on the K13. Two private gliders are out, but I haven't heard anybody launch yet, but anyone could be with us, so keep a good lookout. Cumulus are forming. We've had 25 minutes. Keep us up for another 5. We're starting to move out towards the valley, so a tiny bit of right bank and level the wings again. That's it. We might be weathercocking, so just keep us tracking a bit more to the right. Yes, the wind is more on the ridge, so where he's ahead of us, he's flying away from us, but he's only 150 feet higher.
Good climb here again.
Let me help. We want to keep tracking along here.
Yeah, okay.
That's it. Yours?
Okay.
So we're hoping this will work again.
It's just tiny little pockets of it again, isn't it?
We keep banking gently left and starting to turn out, so that might be a bit of weathercocking. Just try and track us along there.
Okay.
You will. Have you taken one of the blue?
Let me have it in, Mike.
Okay.
From the cable.
Just trying to emulate what he's doing.
Towards the cable.
He's 200 feet. Let's try backing
him.
He's coming down towards us, so it might not be brilliant.
Yeah.
You have control?
I've got it.
Keep the wings level, Mike. Another level, that's it. Okay, he's in the same direction, he's back and he's 200 feet higher. Right, modify now, look. Sorry, I'm just saying, look at your vario.
Yeah.
We want that, so
yeah.
Let's do this. Steady, we're just trying to do very little while it's lifting us. try and do very little while we're going up. Good, see, we're climbing towards him now, so he's come to join us. We're still 150 feet clearance. Did you see him turning away?
Yeah.
If we're not head-to-head, we can carry on as long as we're sure we've seen each other. That's it. See, we keep coming around towards... That's it. If we're flying wings level, the wind will slowly try and turn us towards the valley, then we'll start to move out there.
Yeah.
It'll be a little bit of weathercocking, so we'll just put just a little bit of gentle right bank in every now and again. We're still going up, look.
Yeah.
That's lovely. You've got control.
I can't believe how this is changing every minute.
It only takes a few degrees of wind direction or a few degrees of wind speed to change the ridge. Try the knob here, we're still going up, we're well in. If we have to go back, we've climbed to nearly 1250. The wind won't hit this piece of ridge, so I'd do a left now. Safety look, above and below. Right, now look forward for your turn. Safe speed, string is lovely. Look at the string. That's it. It's more than 180, remember. But as soon as, now the wind's behind us, so slowly start coming right.
PW's 1 o'clock high.
Thank you, look, he's much higher than us, so we want that. You've got to get us up 200 feet on this beat. Feel for it. Turn right now, you'll go too far back. Look at your string, Mike.
Yeah.
Haven't got enough rudder, that's it. Now, same again. Try and do very little now. Here we go. Try and do very little. Hold it steady. Wait, he's at, oh, he's doing, I was about to say, this is so small. If we get another 100 feet or two, we can actually start turning, just so that we're well clear of the ridge. I'd be inclined to turn away from the ridge, though. You see that? We're going up here. This is a good place.
Yeah, this is where it's all happening. Just
stay
this
here,
corner here.
Stay here, let's explore. He's 200 feet above us. Turn right. That's it. Now look forward, check your turn and your string. Nice and gentle, then we don't have to add loads of speed. Right, we flew out of it coming away from the ridge, so we'll go back. It's just about here. Begin to level your wings. See where he is?
Yeah.
We should fly back to it now. The other thing is you'll notice, sometimes with exactly the same place and exactly the same winds, if you've got a slight headwind, sometimes you get a bit of better lift when you're flying with the wind on the nose or vice versa.
Yes.
Right. If you don't mind, stay on the controls, but I'm going to join in here and do something.
Okay.
Good look out for the PW, please. He's above us and might be slightly behind. I think this is a thermal on the side of the hill.
Yeah, he's dead above us.
How high?
Oh.
Well,
at least 300 feet above.
Good, that's what I'm waiting to get out of the way so we can do this. If you notice, we're now turning and left. We're going up pretty fast, we're well clear of the hill. I'm not even going too slow, so we've got good speed on for safety.
Yeah.
My speed is good. Spot him again, would you
please? Yeah, he's 1 o'clock high, same height above us.
Thank you.
Turning the same way, he's a bit further back behind us now.
I suspect this might be a thermal, but it could be this gully behind, just be it on our left here.
Yeah.
So we're up to 6 knots now.
Yeah.
So we might catch him up.
He's directly above us now. That was him going through the sun.
Can you still see him?
Yeah, he's still...
Is he turning the same direction as us?
Still going. Not as tight as us.
No, is he turning in the same direction?
Yes.
I don't want to fly out of this. I could probably release the bank a little bit and still go up.
Yeah, he's dead in front of us now.
Good. As long as he's
1 o'clock, still high, still 200 or 300 feet above us. Still turning the same way as us.
Are you on the controls?
I'm following you through, yeah.
Right, take over please.
Okay.
Try and keep the same bank and speed.
Okay, I've got it.
And string, you have control. Right, play that, mate. Don't let the speed build up or we'll fly out of it. Look where he is above us now.
Yeah, now we're getting closer to him height-wise.
Yes, he's come back to us. He should adjust, but we won't take any chances. If he's not in the same circle, we'll adjust. That's me.
Okay. He's gone away now. He's flying away.
Excellent. Keep going then. We're going up like a rocket. That's it. Don't look too long down the wing. It's a safety check. Now don't look too long in the cockpit either.
Yeah.
Okay? So check your speed, your attitude, your string, your lift. Another look for safety in the direction of the turn and all around. And all around. Then back to the instruments. That's it, matey. See the lift, the wing's trying to lift up, it's so strong.
Yeah.
So what have we got? You happy with your height?
Yeah.
You happy we're clear of the ridge? See the wing's coming up again from the inside.
Yeah.
It's trying to lift. That'll throw us out. Look at the PW, we're higher than it.
Yeah.
And we're still going up at 6 knots. We're 2,500. Are you happy?
Yeah, absolutely.
My heart's going ballistic. You have control.
I've got control.
Remember, the wing tries to lift just here, so make sure it doesn't come up. If it doesn't come up, you're okay. We've had 30 minutes now.
Okay.
We've got four people for this. Your turning's coming on really well, actually. It's really simple discipline. I'm going to turn. A really good look back above and behind the wing. Then I check over the nose to make sure I'm getting it right. Look above us. See the cloud forming?
Yeah.
We're in that. You happy your speed's safe for this little bit of turbulence?
Yes, I'm happy with that.
I am too, yeah, it feels good. Because you haven't said, whoa!
Yeah.
So when it's a bit bumpier, and you're unsure, you haven't been on the ridge, you know, a bit of extra speed.
Just fly this way, but I think we're flying out of it at that end.
Yep, yep. Look above, the cloud will help you. There's another cloud forming there and there. Has PW gone in?
Well, there's something way down below us.
Yes, I think he...
Okay, let's have a look at it. Go on around then. I've lost this.
It's gone, but I've lost it. Well, you know, we've just over those two towers. If you've levelled your wings, we'll fly out of it, so you know it's there somewhere. Level the wings now and go forward. Right, he was actually on his landing approach. He was rolling on the ground, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Was he? No, he's not.
No, he's flying up to high key, isn't he? Yeah.
We've got, it's midday, we've got 3 or 4 more hours of this lift. Look at it, he's flown too high key and now he's gone downwind. I'll just say we've got 3 or 4 more hours, so if everybody had one 45 minute flight save, we'll all get plenty.
Yeah.
Probably the secret is to wait till they call us. Ken's down there, he'll call us. So, stalling then, we've got good height. Have you had a spin demonstration?
I haven't had a spin, no.
Would you like a spin demonstration?
Yes, please.
You've had 12 or 13 flights now?
Yes.
And you have had stall demonstrations?
I've had stall demonstrations and I've done one. Obviously, I did them back in the day as well, but... Okay. Yeah.
Well, let's fly out till we no longer have the hill underneath us.
Okay.
If that's lift, take it. So we'll keep going and... There you go, you see we've got a bit of lift. Just ease the speed off and stay into wind. We'll take that. That's that. Probably the start of that thermal again.
Yeah.
So just fly through it, just taking the height. In fact, I gently turn right, I think, just based on the cloud. Maybe that'll do. Just take that as we fly gently through the thermal. Add a bit of extra height. Okay, so, stall, can you remember the stall symptoms?
Loss of control, buffeting, slowing speed.
For you, Mike.
Yeah.
Okay, so I have control.
You've control.
You have the controls?
Yeah.
Just going to turn gently into the wind. Keep an eye that nobody's getting ready to launch. We're over the valley, we've got maximum height below us.
Yeah.
So, stalling, obviously, there's a range of symptoms. I think there's 9 altogether.
Yeah.
So usually the attitude is an indicator. If that's our normal gliding attitude, our nose is high.
Yeah.
Our brain should be telling us we're slowing down.
Yeah.
We can see it on the ASI, it is slowing down.
Yeah.
It's getting quieter, that's associated with those two things.
Yeah.
6 coming back, the nose is still coming up. Controls are getting sloppy.
Yeah.
Not getting much bite from them.
Yeah.
Feel the buffet.
Yeah.
And then the other thing is, the nose goes down with the stick back.
Yeah.
The wing's going down, I'm just going to let the stick come forward and do that again. Don't want to do a spin just yet, so. Feel the buffet, get your fingertips on the stick.
Yeah.
See, the nose has gone down, the stick is still back.
Yeah.
We have to just ease the stick forward. You can see the speed's back, the noise has come back.
Yeah.
So that was a gentle stall.
Okay.
We do that when we're turning. I'm going to do a hassle check now and we'll do a spin demonstration. Make sure that you're secure. So our height is adequate. 2,000 feet. In fact, I'm going to try and scan a bit more so we can do two. But have a good scan on for other traffic, especially our own. The airframe is stressed for this. We're allowed to do stalls. We've got good height.
Yeah.
Loose objects, I haven't got any. You got any?
No.
That is secure your hood?
Yeah.
Straps?
Straps are secure.
Location is good. No engine. That was my... Right, we're going to do a spin.
Okay.
So it'll be a stall. We will be stalled.
Yeah.
So you'll see those symptoms.
Yeah.
I'm going to do it from a gentle turn, which is the classic stall scenario.
Yeah.
We're going too slow and we're trying to turn. You feel that there's a bit of a buffet?
Yes.
So I'm going to try and generate it. I'm going to come up a wee bit more. We're going too slow in a thermal say.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can do it now. Right, that's gone into a spin. It's full opposite rudder. Stick fully forward. I just said to you, stick fully forward. It's full opposite rudder, so it's onto the stop.
Yeah.
Got to make sure we don't do it again. Stick forward centrally. We don't have to shove it forward. We end up in a too deep a dive.
Yeah.
I should just be able to try one more. We'll do the same direction. But you have to be careful. The VNE on this is 106. We mustn't exceed that.
Yeah.
Ideally, you don't get even close to it. So let's do again. We're thermaling now.
Yeah.
As opposed to a slow, underbanked, over-rudder turn.
I've
not going to let it go fully in, so then I'm going to push the nose fully forward.
Yeah.
I didn't want to go fully in because we've lost some height.
Yeah.
But that's what happens. You saw the stall. If you stall while you're turning, you'll spin 99% of the time.
Okay.
If you stall while you're yawed, you will. So we're erect like this, and we're yawing.
Yeah.
And I stall us.
Yeah.
That wing will go down, the backward going wing.
Okay.
So that's why it's important to stay coordinated when you're turning. Take control, please.
Okay, I've got it.
We have had over near 35 or 6 minutes. If you wish, you can just trundle along the wing and see if we can get an extra 5 or 10, sorry, along the ridge before they call us back. So head for the trees. So that is a spin demonstration. We've done a stall and a spin demonstration. And I recovered from an incipient spin on the second one. So as the wing went down, I moved the stick forward.
Yeah.
That unstalled us before we started auto-rotating. Get onto the ridge. You've got to get over to the ridge here. Let me help. So maybe we'll go to the nearest bit, which is just here. There you go, matey. It's yours. You have control.
Okay.
Yeah, your turning's coming on really well, actually. So, but remember, safety look. Start your turn looking over the nose so you get everything set up. And then within a second or two, safety look again in the direction of the turn. That's nice. Isn't that nice?
Cheers.
That. 4 knots, I'm getting 2 meters. Yeah, so when the, you concentrate and I'll talk. Are you okay for me talking about spinning?
Yeah, yeah.
So we stalled, we started auto-rotating. We do full opposite rudder, that's to stop the auto-rotation. Almost instantaneously we move the stick in the center. We just move it forward. It doesn't have to be a huge push. If you push it forward, you dive as steeper and you pull out as harder. So you unstall us by moving the stick forward.
Yeah.
As soon as we stop rotating, you centralize the rudder and make sure you're pulling out to the dive. If we're getting anywhere near VNE, you just pull smoothly but firmer.
Yeah.
You keep moving it back until the speed stops increasing. At that point, you can just hold it. As the nose comes up, we'll slow down anyway. There you go, we've added some more. We might have enough height for another spin. Go back, because it's sinking now. And we've gone well off the ends. So there's the fishing lake ahead, look. Oh, you don't drive past that, do you?
No.
Launch point, this is K13. Now, we won't be too much longer. We're going to get a bit more height for one more spin. That was the circumvent being told to come back.
Sure.
Back onto the ridge, Mike. Let's get some height. And see if that thermal's there at the other end of it. That's good, your string. Your coordination is very good. But you know what? If you look down the wing just as you're turning and you keep looking down the wing, 9 times out of 10 your rudder coordination will suffer.
Yeah. It's just a natural thing.
Over the top, we need to be over towards our crest just here. Now, there you go. Look at that. Look at the barrier. Yeah, no, it's like car driving. You want to look where you're talking.
That's right. That's the problem. You just get so used to it in a car, and it's not what you do.
And the other thing, even when we're turning, once we're in a turn, say you're in a thermal, we're actually scanning. We're scanning horizontally, not down the wind.
Yeah.
So looking down the wind is. Go back around again. There was you missed most of that lift because we were too far back.
Look forward
a couple of seconds. Right foot, just pointing at your right foot. There you go. Now remember the roads and the clearings and things. Follow, scan along there. We might not get enough. We've got 30. We've done 14 minutes. We can't get up high. Trying to go and see, we're turning away again, Mike.
Yeah.
If in your mind you want to go along there, you've got to stop that weathercocking doing that to you.
Yeah.
Just a few little adjustments. Sometimes you set it perfectly, you can go the whole length of the ridge without any adjustments. Anyway, that was good. Spin demonstration, something on your card.
Yes, it's not often that you get enough height to be able to do things like that.
Well, we will from now on, we'll get loads of it.
Yeah.
There you go, may I?
Yeah, you've got it.
Thank you. You stay on. There you go, it's yours. Take
okay.
It back now, we're nearly still. That was a gust. Now the gust may have artificially increased our airspeed there, so we don't want to be doing anything silly. But it'll also try and just blow us back a wee bit too, so just little adjustments, you'll get the hang of it. You're doing really well actually, we've climbed another 100 feet. Can't see any clouds forming in the immediate area. Not high enough to fly. Look at that. Dead smooth, don't do much at all. If it's working well, you do very little. Look at that. Where are we? Right on the knob, on the final knob as well. Look at that. Another 100 feet. Another 150 feet. Beauty. Doing really well. The string is lovely, so we're properly trimmed. Make any little adjustments in the direction of the nose, stick and rudder together and level them again.
Yeah.
If you try and use the rudder, it just creates drag and you'll lose any benefit or lots of the benefit. So that's nice. It's just beginning to weaken, we're still climbing, but now I would turn. And you're going to do more than 180, it's because we know back there it's behind us, isn't it? Somebody has launched. I can't see anybody in the immediate threat area. You concentrate on getting back to the same place on the ridge. I turn now because you'll blow back too far, too quick, really quickly. Look at your string. It's asking for a bit of right foot. It's a right bank. You probably need a little bit of right foot.
Yep.
There you go. I'll tell you what, Mike.
Yeah.
If you're happy we've got enough height, good luck for safety. Start to turn. There's the other glide. He's well clear, way down
the
road.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Turn now, actually. This way.
Oh, that way. Sorry.
That's all right with you? You happy?
Yeah, yeah.
We're well clear of the ridge?
Yeah.
The best of it is now forward, so maybe your right turn would have been better. So we'll see. We'll get back into it in a second. There's a cloud above us.
Just edge forward a bit.
Level wings now to extend us out a little bit.
Yeah.
Level wings now, that's it. Look for your barrier. Look at your barrier. Right, we're going into the wind a little bit, so we're not going to go quite as fast over the ground. The other glide is, I think he's thermal, he's still a mile
yes,
away.
Yes, yeah, yeah, I've got him.
Look at your vario, just gently come towards the hill again. Just need a little bit more if we're going to do another spin. That's it. I would like a wee bit more actually, just to get us. We'll lose. You can lose. By the time you've dived and recovered, you can still lose 300-400 feet.
Yeah.
By the time you, if you spin, the bottom of your recovery is too low to survive if you're on your final turn.
Yeah.
So you might say, oh, I only lost 400 feet. But you've probably gone down over 600 feet.
Definitely lost.
It's not great. Go back again and did what you did before when we added 200 feet. We're probably over the top of them. We're 300 feet clear. That's the Vega. Good. Look at your string and all your turn indicators are ahead of you. Your safety is to your right. Beautiful. String's lovely. Rolled out of that beautifully. Beautiful coordinated rollout. So now try and find that again and go up. So now we've lost that 300 feet we gained on the last one. So we probably won't be able to do another spin demo.
Come on, where have you gone?
Just jumble forward, you'll move into it, position yourself. I think we can go slightly forward rather than to the right. As soon as the needle starts moving, allow us to come to the right gently. Sometimes like this, it's almost you're just thinking about it rather than doing things.
Yeah.
You'll think about a slight movement to the right and it, string's lovely, it means we're nicely cleaned up. Now make us move gently to the right along those clearings. I think that's where we were last time. For your ground positioning, obviously you need to look down where we were physically, if nothing's changed. We're just gently turn, the nose keeps swinging out again, so track us that way. Around here somewhere. Obviously not just yet, but there's a bit of air mixing.
Here it comes.
Right, now help it a tad with a couple of knots off. If it stays noisy, it means we're still safe. But if it goes quiet like that, there you go, help it a tad.
EG202 online, remaining cable, take up slack.
We had 8 knots briefly there.
Yeah.
Remaining.
Have you got knots on yours at the front?
No, I've got meters on mine.
Yeah, I went to 4 meters. Right, so I would go back around again and try to get back to the same spot. Now, we know he's out there, so really good look. Good look, right back, because we're going to go right round. Start your turn gently, because that will help you with your scan. Nice and gentle, so we don't surprise him.
Yeah, can't see him anywhere.
Maybe above us, because he was doing quite well.
All out.
Well, we're going to go back here, aren't we? So, no, stay on the controls, Mike. I'm going to play. Look for him, could you? Any sign?
Nope. Can't see him anywhere.
I'm just having a feel for whatever that was, in case I can circle in it, or you can circle in it. We'll have to go back.
There
shortly.
He is, right off our nose. 11 o'clock miles.
Same glider.
Well, there's one down there anyway.
Okay. Well, I'm not sure. I mean, it probably is. But keep looking, as always. Here we go, there's a little bit here. So now that I've found it, I'm just going to try and tighten up in it. You okay?
Yep.
And trim's right back. So we're pulling, if we go dead slow, when you're pulling this tight, you're going to need a bit of speed on to get around, so keep us safe. We'll speed at a higher speed when we're back to the earth. Just hoping this will give us enough to, I think that is going to go out a tiny bit, to try and find it stronger here.
Right, is it our 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock?
Yeah, I think it's taking a wee bit long. I think we should go back, actually. You happy?
Yeah.
Right, take control then, would you, Mike?
Okay, I've got it.
You have control.
I have control.
Don't let speed build up. That's it. If you do find really strong lift, I mean, take us back then to...
Okay, let's just go around once more.
Yeah, okay. He's staying in the valley. Keep it smooth now. You're Mr. Smooth, so don't ruin it. Level the wings now, fly out to the valley. Good look ahead. That's the PW on the ground, I think, so both tragic gliders are up. There's one on our left at 11 o'clock, so just below.
It's the other one, I don't know where it is.
Well, that's why we'll keep scanning. We'll all tend to stay within 2 or 3 miles of each other, so.
Well, there he is. They're both in the same. One's right over the ridge, hardly moving.
There's a cloud above, so. Try, another go. If we can get a really strong thermal, we can. Yeah, here's one. Give yourself a few seconds and go in now. Look for the other glider, he's out here on our left.
Yeah.
But concentrate on keeping your turn neat. Safety instruments. So that's it. Can you take the back pressure off me? That's it, you have control.
I have control.
So take it off me, if you keep some back pressure on.
Yeah.
With the aircraft trimmed all the way back, we still want to do 50.
Yeah.
So just keep a little bit of back pressure on. He's on the nose, he's lower. in a different place to us. See, I'm just trying to do that. Can you feel that back pressure?
Yeah.
Do that then, so that the nose doesn't go down. Have you got it?
Yeah.
Keep it back.
Okay.
That's it. That's it, good man. Look forward as well. And your scan when you're looking in the direction of the turn is horizontal, not down the wing. You've got to look around here. That's it. There's him. Can't see the other guy. Good, we may get the spin after all. Keep the back pressure on, Mike. I've just got my finger wrapped around it so I can feel it when you relax it.
Yeah.
Look at your rudder position. So this is a fully coordinated turn. Yeah, you're actually, if you just keep the turn going, just try and keep everything the same. They'll come under us. There's one, the other one's coming towards us. They're all, both 300 or 400 feet below us. So we, oh, no, look at that. That's it. Good, I mean, you're keeping a really good look out. Your string is in a reasonably good position. Everything you need to do a really good turn is ahead of you. Your safety is out there on our left at the moment. That's it, but keep the turn on, that's it. Otherwise we'll fly out of it.
It's off our wingtip now, the one.
Okay, they're well clear. Concentrate on your turn for now. We can spot them every time we come round. They'll both come here probably because they're both lower. So they'll want this. Remember that?
Yeah.
Keep going, we'll have enough to do a spin. We have now actually. We'll carry on up. That's me, because I've got my finger in front of it. When you let the nose go down, I can feel it.
Yeah.
See, the nose went down. It takes a few seconds, but it will accelerate.
Yes.
And then you may fly out of the lift. So if we can try and keep everything just dead smooth. You know the rule, do very little in place unless the atmosphere does something, you know, it moves you. Go out towards the airfield now. Because the lift is better just here. That's it, now go turn in again. Look forward for your turn. Forward for your turn, that's it. See, as you were turning then, the nose came up.
Yeah.
Because you were looking down the wing. You missed it. Right, let's go out there and land. So head for a high key out there. That's it, roundabout. Beautiful. We'll leave that to those guys. Put a bit of speed on, take us out now towards the winch. Beauty. That's enough speed, just to penetrate. We'll probably have 15 knots on the nose here, so we're only doing, what are we doing now, 35 over the ground. They'll probably stay there and use that, so we'll do a hassle check. Tell you what we'll do, we'll land in 5-6 minutes, that'll give us an hour. So hassle. Height is sufficient, it is.
Yeah.
Airframe is stressed for spinning, we're allowed to spin in this.
Okay.
We do security and straps. No, so there's no loose objects?
No.
Straps are secure.
Yeah.
If we add an engine, we do whatever we need to do, we don't. Then we've got lookout and location. So we're over open space now. Hassle check is a 180 and a 180. Fairly steep so we can look down.
Okay.
So do one now. It's a proper turn. So we have a good look around and there's people and down below us. Look for anything flying towards us. He's a bit close, but we'll do it anyway. Turn and go the other way now, Mike.
He's coming across underneath.
We're doing a hassle here.
Yeah, he's coming right across underneath us, mate.
Okay.
It's right underneath us.
Okay. Okay. Okay, negative to that, we've lost the height waiting for you. Okay, we'll come in and land.
Okay.
Right, there's something interesting to do, Mike. Do another stall, actually.
Okay.
We've just done a hassle, I hope he's not underneath us. So it's a gentle stall. Bring the nose up. Tell me what's happening. The nose is high.
Yeah, the nose is high, going quieter. Slower. Losing all control.
nose goes down. You see the easy stick forward?
Yeah.
The nose goes down, we pick up our speed. That was a gentle run.
Okay.
If that happened accident, you'd say, oops!
Yeah.
And you'd and we'd recover.
Yeah.
Pull out some air brake. Just gently, now we're going to lose the height and go in and land. We've got 4 minutes to go.
Head up
the valley, so you're going to gently go towards Lakeview.
We're moving away from the road because the cables are dropping perilously close.
That's plenty. So that's plenty of air brake.
Have you found the wind drop?
Can't believe that. Heckin' hell. We're doing a hassle check. We went in two directions. He's ahead of us, can you see?
Yeah.
1 o'clock.
Yeah, I've got him.
Same height, we're descending towards him. We're doing a bloody hassle check and he flew underneath us.
Yeah.
But that hassle check is to spot that. We saw him coming. But it meant we had to carry on around. We lost the extra 300 or 400 feet I wanted. So just ease the brakes in now. And we'll just trundle out of the way. It's a damn nuisance. That would have been a good spin in the other direction. We're well clear of Edwards' Road. While we're here, have a look at the hedgerow between us and Edwards.
Yeah.
Extended out past our gate.
Yeah.
It's this side of those green sheds.
Yeah.
Extended out now. See the white sign? It's this sign of that first white sign.
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Extended out again. Can you see the tree in the field?
Yes.
That big tree in the field, this side of the white sign.
Yeah.
We don't go past that. You
okay.
Extend it right up the valley. Look now, I'll take control for a sec.
Okay.
See that big set of sheds and buildings there ahead, directly ahead.
Yeah.
Directly ahead.
Yeah.
The line, his line goes all the way up there.
Right, okay.
But it stops just by the... But you can see how much land we can't use, unless
we're over
2,000. There's one over there on the ridge, that's the PW, he's got a nose wheel. Reverse our turn now, Mike, please. Oh yeah, I'd go left to keep away from them. I'll tell you what I do want to do. We haven't got the air brakes, I don't think so.
No.
What would be nice is just to add 2 or 3 minutes to make it an hour, and we won't get it if we land now, so...
Okay.
Let's just try here. For a thermal, there's a cloud above us. Let me take control if I
You've
may.
Got it, yeah.
If we don't get some height now, we'll go downwind from here. Whatever happens now, that's going to be an hour in your logbook.
Okay. There we go. Come on.
We are going up, so it's just holding us. That's all we need for now. We might just get back to 800 so we can go out into the valley and do our... That's good. We're going up. So we just go back into the valley and you can start... Oh, ideally, start from about 800 and fly a circuit for me. Gentle turn, because without putting too much speed on, I can turn gently.
Yeah.
Still be safe. If I want to turn really sharp, especially over the hill, you want a bit of speed on.
It's always better in this direction, or it has been all day. I'm really glad Gino walked off.
Well, he'll have a good time. We expect these conditions all day, so we're hoping. But while these guys stay up, they're always giving us hints. PW's a little better performer, although this is quite good in weak lift. In good lift, that'll go up better. But the other two will point out, they'll perform a bit better. They can travel further and find lift. But while the wind stays more or less doing this, I think we can go in and claim your hour. You take control now. I'll start the turn. That's me putting the speed on to get us down the wind. There's any lift. Man, you fly it. If I hit some lift, I'm going to ease the speed off. There you go. There's a bit.
Yeah.
Just to add a little bit of height as we're getting downwind. That's me. I'm just taking advantage of that zero. Vario.
Yeah.
Now we put our speed back on. So we're in about, if we turn off at 700 feet downwind, we're in the right place. So keep flying towards the power lines. We don't want to get any further away. The wind will try and blow us away. You have control.
I've got control.
Add some speed. We're going to land, we said, what's the wind doing? Yes, we're going to land at 60 knots. Okay. Keep it from rocking around, Mike. Keep 50 knots on. Trim for 50. Don't look at it. That's it. Safety look up the valley ahead of us in case anybody's coming towards us. To our left in case they're coming towards the same place. This is now our diagonal. So we'll use this diagonal. See the way we're blowing to the left?
Yeah.
We don't want to go too far away. Just a gentle turn to the right to lay off some of that. Level the wings, keep not less than 50. This is a diagonal now, so we are using this to position ourselves for our base leg. We'll land to the right of the big tree in the center.
Yeah.
Put more speed on now, please. Make it 55. We said 60, but we'll stay 60. Stay at 60. Trim for 60, Mike. Don't look at it, just move it forward. That's it. A base leg. When you're ready, 90 degrees to our runway, keep your speed on, that's it, level the wings, this is the base leg, level the wings, start your final turn now, don't let the speed come up, so keep the speed on, that's it, keep the speed on, look at your speed every now and again, that's it, use a little bit of air brake now, when you're ready, you happy to land it? Okay, do you want me to take control? I have control.
You have control.
You stay on the controls. Now just going to see rotators with the rudder in the direction we're going to land in. Watch carefully. I might lose control. We've got some shelter here, luckily.
Jesus.
It's a mess, isn't it, here? See the wind, the nose is going to the right, to the left.
Yeah.
There was a little bit of weathercocking right at the end. Bloody brilliant.
That was a fantastic flight. Right,